Good afternoon to all the respected dignitaries, honorable speakers, honorable chairperson, jury members, and my dear friends. I, Purvi Tripathi, really feel honored to be the part of third International Conference on Document Examination organized by IASR for the year 2021. Today, I will be presenting my research on the topic variations in handwriting characteristics due to different grip patterns. Means, does your grip or effect do the effect on your handwriting characters? That is, does it create any kind of variations in your handwriting characteristics? Because talking about the grip, it's nothing but how a person holds a writing instrument and write it on a particular writing surface. Okay, the identification of the writer in the field of document examination and in forensic science basically is on the basis of attributes like gender, age, health, their handness characteristics, their handwriting characteristics, like their individual characteristics, their general characteristics. So can grip be characteristics which can induce variations in your handwriting? So with this, I would like to introduce my topic with the introduction slide. Basically, we all know that handwriting is the result of neuromuscular coordination, where images of alphabets are formed in the brain. Means only not our hand and fingers are responsible for creating the handwriting, but also our brain works on it. The image that is formed in the brain, we just form it on our writing surfaces. So handwriting as an evidence is considered as helpful part of the information for forensic investigations, as we all know, which commonly encountered in the cases like murder, suicide, kidnappings, etc. So moving forward to the next slide, the pencil grasp, or you can say the pen grab, is a term which is used to describe the position of the fingers involved in grasping a pencil. Two distinct types of grips were described by Niebuhr in 1956 as the power grip and a precision grip. Generally, there are two kinds of pencil or pen grip, which is described by Selin in 2003, which was classified as efficient grip and inefficient grip. Efficient grip includes four kinds of grips: the lateral tripod, the dynamic quadrupod, and the static tripod. Okay, this is the the form how an individual holds a pen. So mainly the common type of efficient grip, which is found in the maximum population, is a dynamic tripod grasp, which was proved by Venin and Perry in 1966 in their research paper. Moving forward to the slide, we have inefficient grip. Inefficient grip are further classified as fisted, thumb wrap, thumb tuck, index, and adapted. These are very, you get it in a very less population, you get a very less sample, but yes, they are present. I have a lot of volunteer who have given me their samples, as an adapted tripod was very common in inefficient grip. So moving ahead, is the justification for my research. Basically, the analysis of handwriting documents from the viewpoint of determining the writer has great bearing on the criminal justice system, as we all know this. Handwriting and handprinting identifications have been performed since the late 1800s. Since each person's handwriting and handprinting habits are unique, it can be established whether someone wrote a certain word, initials, or document. That is a very common principle of a document on which the whole document, forensic document examination, rely. No other crime is so prevalent in our society as the crime related to the documents. Crime with guns, bombs, and other crime of violence draw attention of media and the public. Wherever, however, crimes committed with documents involve billions of dollars and accurately have a great impact on our global economy. In order to analyze and identify a handwritten document, grip also play an important role, which give a particular type of handwriting with different handwriting characteristics. This can help a document expert to eliminate a suspect or a group of suspect on the basis of their grip patterns also. I'm talking about this can be done on the preliminary level, because as much I have started my research, the preliminary level elimination is possible. So moving ahead with the next slide, the main objective of my research was to analyze and characterize variable handwriting features in different grip patterns. That the different grip patterns have the different variable handwriting features, and to compare the handwriting features of disguised grip patterns with the genuine grip patterns. Because as we all know, criminals are very smart minded, how much we think they are more far smarter than us. So in cases where the ransom letters or the kidnapping letters or any kind of letters are sent to a particular victim house or them, they generally disguise their handwriting so that their identification cannot be done. So they can do like swiping their hands, writing from left hands, or in some cases it has been found that they have disguise their grip also, like holding a pen in a thumb raffle and writing on a large surfaces in a form of warning words or warning letters, whatever. So how and handwriting, if so we can compare that if a disguised grip pattern is different from the genuine grip pattern of a particular individual or not. So moving ahead, I have a lot of samples, results, and everything, so I cannot comply all those in all these 10 slides. So I've just shown that how my results were formed. So in this study, basically, I have taken 130 samples, which were collected from 65 volunteers. Two samples have been collected from each volunteer, out of which one was their genuine grip, like the natural uniqueness of the grip they have already, and the other was their disguised grip, like a static tripod has been disguised with adaptive tripod. So is there any differences? We need to find out. So the general handwriting characteristics of different grips was analyzed and evaluated. The general characteristics which I took particularly for my research was slant, alignment, word spacing, the letter size ratio, and speed were observed, and the chi-squares value were calculated. The statistics analysis were done on the basis of the chi-square values and on the p-square values. So like features like slant have been taken, and the category were described, left, vertical, and right. So how many percentage of people have a left slant in for a particular grip? Like for static tripod, I have taken samples. So I have described in the features like slant. So how many of the static tripod individual have left slant, have vertical slant, and have right slant? And that is shown with the help of the bar graph also. And then the study showed that using the method described, it is possible to classify and evaluate a large quantity of information concerning the role of grip in establishing the identity of the individual. None of the researchers till now have classified and evaluated the general characteristics of different grip patterns, and also the comparison between the genuine and disguised grip, in order to draw a conclusion about identity of the writer up to certain extent, which can help the forensic document expert to eliminate suspect or a group of suspects on primary preliminary level. This study is to find out basically to find out the variation in handwriting characteristics due to different grip patterns, statistically using chi-square and p-test. The chi-square value that I have found was more than the significant value of the chi-square, which was 5.99%, and the result that shows was more than 5.99%, which shows that the results are significant. That it generally rejects my null hypothesis that there is no variation in handwriting characteristics in different grip patterns. But the results show that yes, there is a variations in handwriting due to different grips. And the P square value that I have got was all less than 0.05, which is the standard P square value for the statistics analysis, which also shows that the significant values are correct for the particular analysis. The result showed that the grip of an individual can also play a role in individual handwriting formation, which can be used for forensic document examination for establishing writer's identity. The general handwriting characteristics feature is analyzed and evaluated. And if talking about the disguise and the natural handwriting, this is very less or slight. There was very less and slight differences in the handwriting characteristics when genuine grip handwriting features are compared with the disguised grip, which means if a person tries to change its grip with other grip, there is no variation can be found. The writing variations will be same as their genuine one. Like the letter space size ratio will be same, and the spacing will be same, but there will be a little difference which you cannot conclude for your result. So I have established that there cannot be differences in the within the genuine and the disguised grip. So I have moving toward the first next slide. I am still researching on this topic. It's not completed. I am still researching, and I will do until and unless I get my desired result. So the recommendation for the future research scope can be like, since the principle of handwriting states that no two people write exactly alike in extended handwriting sample, every individual has its own features and characteristics of handwriting. The amount of samples can be taken more for each grip. Like I have taken only 130 samples till now. To get a proper statistical database for a particular grip, you need to take a more and more sample you take for each grip, the more efficient and specific result you will get. So the samples can be taken for more for the each grip for further research, which can give a more accurate result about the specific characteristics of each grip, which can differ with the other in one or more way. Ultimately, it can also lead to establish the authorship of writing in more significant way. And here are my references.